And in those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea, saying, "Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." It was tough preaching. Many people denied me, and many left for their worldly possessions. However, many believed and were baptized in the living water of Jesus the Messiah. So, there comes the Messiah himself, my cousin, Jesus. He came over the mountainside and walked straight toward me. I thought he was going to preach to us, but instead, he walks right up to me and says, "You shall baptize me." I was confused and told him that he should be the one baptizing me. Well, he insisted, so I agreed. Right when I poured the water on his head, the heavens opened up, and a beautiful white dove came down and flew over Jesus. Right then, I heard a booming voice saying, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." After I baptized him, he thanked me and left, going out into the desert. I continued my preaching of his word and baptized many people. It was generally the same outcome. Some believed, some didn't. Eventually, many people wouldn't leave my side because they always wanted to hear more of the good news. One day, Herod imprisons me and puts me in jail for preaching against him. I waited for weeks. One day, Herod's guard comes into the room and brings me to him. It turns out his daughter asked for my head on a platter. Next thing I know, I'm in a giant room with a lot of people. That's the last thing I remember. But many people in heaven told me that many believed and were baptized because of my death. Thank you for listening. Forget all the rules. Forget everything. You took my name out of schools. I take back my blessings.